the signal to go live? Yes, perfect. So good evening, everybody. Good evening, Your Excellency, Ambassador, distinguished guests and friends of our Litvak Days. It is a great pleasure to welcome you to our annual event, which this year will take place for the 10th time. After a very difficult year, we are delighted to welcome you both in person here at the embassy and online on Facebook and YouTube. Our program this year, as you can tell probably, focuses on the history, legacy, and art, and the connection between the Lithuanian Jews to South Africa and to the UK. We hope that these 2 days, today and tomorrow, filled with keynote speeches, discussions by esteemed scholars, professors, panelists, and experts, will prove to be enriching and thought-provoking. Right now, without any further ado, I would like to introduce Ambassador of Lithuania to the UK, Renatas Norkus, for his welcoming remarks.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends. It's a pleasure for me to see so many familiar faces and welcome you to the embassy this evening. Also, I want to welcome all the people and friends that are joining us online today. As you know, things go, we are learning how to do hybrid things nowadays. It would have been lovely to see even more people tonight in person. Unfortunately, the conditions are still so that we have to do it you know, in a more sophisticated way. But there's some positive sides to that, because we can connect, you know, anywhere in the world. We can connect to Cape Town, we can connect to Toronto, Washington, you know, you name it, Australia, everywhere. And that's what we are learning to do last couple of years, especially last 15, 16, 17 months. I'm delighted to launch, with the help of you, Stan, with the help of all the team at the embassy, to launch our annual event, Litvak Days. Some of you, or perhaps most of you, have already had the chance to participate in those days previously. Traditionally, we organize them in London by this embassy, also in cooperation with our partners that are many and they are growing. And it is the 10th anniversary. So 10 years we've been doing that. Rain or shine, winter or spring. Normally we would gather in autumn like this year. But there have been years where we would alternate and move it to the springtime. But there was never a pause. There was never a year that we would miss such an important event. And I'm so delighted that we can continue this tradition today. So every year we invite our honorary guests to explore some specific aspects of Litvak identity and heritage, be it distinguished personalities and events or influence to the world of science, culture, and arts in a more specific way. This year's Litvak Days are dedicated to the South African Litvak community and its contribution to the longevity of the Litvak identity and memory. You could ask, why South Africa? I'm being told that of the South African Jewish community, around 90% come from Lithuania or the Litvak, original Litvak areas. It's quite significant, isn't it? And people have been traveling. I mean, it's a journey. Our life is a journey. We are living as long as we are traveling. So people have been traveling from Lithuania to other European countries, and many of them ended up in South Africa. And now the new generation is reconnecting back to Europe through London, through United Kingdom, because of a very close relationship between South Africa and United Kingdom. It's been fascinating to see how many talented Jewish community people that ended up in South Africa have been growing and have been contributing in all spheres of life. So I wanted to recognize tonight the High Commissioner of South Africa. Unfortunately, I understand she is either stuck in traffic or she's still maybe on the way. Maybe we can see her a little bit later. But she was very excited to hear about this event. During two in-depth sessions tomorrow, the prominent South African, Lithuanian, and the UK representatives of academia, art, and culture will be exploring the topics of history and art and cultural heritage. The program also includes the initiatives of the forthcoming project CONUS, European Culture Capital 2022, implemented in cooperation with the prominent creators from South Africa. Every Litvak Days that we host represent unique storytelling. As such initiatives are symbolic, Litvak's community's trips to their historical homeland, an opportunity to enrich the knowledge and understanding for all those interested in Jewish history and cultural heritage. It is also a venue for exchanges of memories and inspiring personal stories, like the one told by our dear friend Mark Furman, who is here today with us. Mark, yes, he's here. He and his family traveled back to Lithuania. His family comes from South Africa, and they traveled back to Lithuania in April of 2019. Selwyn and Merle Furman, the parents, they visited Panevėžys, also Pumpėnai, and Vebelninkas, where Selwyn's family all lived. We were so delighted to have contributed to their journey and to rediscovery of Lithuania a couple of years ago. It's a personal story. I'm sure Mark will be happy to share some aspects of it maybe tomorrow. So thank you very much for joining us tonight. So those stories, there are plenty of them, and we are here to try to help you present those interesting living memories. It was that particular trip, by the way, where they first met Ms. Faina Kuklansky, the chairperson of the Lithuanian community, of Jewish community in Lithuania, who is with us tonight. Thank you very much, Faina, for joining us. She just flew from Toronto today after having had interesting events, some cultural events also in Canada. Thank you very much. And Faina will be speaking for us tomorrow. It is worth mentioning that London Litvak Days, having been the first to be organized 10 years ago, now is only one of many events of this kind. Annually organized by the Lithuanian diplomatic representations worldwide, from analogous Litvak Days in Boston, in Paris, just a few months ago, a few weeks ago, to thematic events on Jewish culture and history in Denmark, Poland, Moldova, Russia, the Netherlands, Israel, and many others. Last year was exceptionally rich in events dedicated to the 300th birth anniversary of the great Vilna Gaon. As our tradition goes, we are kicking our event tonight with a concert, with a cultural program. So this evening, ladies and gentlemen, you will have an opportunity to hear two world-renowned Lithuanian musicians, Gleb Pyšniak, he's a cellist, and Rokas Zubovas, a piano player, who will perform music pieces by Anatolijus Šenderovas, Vidmantas Bartulis, and Faustas Latėnas in a program that they titled Legends. Juste will later briefly introduce our two musicians, who happen to be also my personal friends. I'm so happy that every time we are able to invite them back to London to perform. Tomorrow's program also includes the premiere of a new audiovisual project, the music Shell by Chromaticon, which is part of Kaunas, European Capital of Culture 2022 memory program. Kaunas is our second largest city in Lithuania, and they will be exceptionally active next year. So we decided to bring you some teaser tomorrow of that program. So I hope you will be enjoying that too. We'd also like to use this opportunity to thank our partners and contributors who made this event's program possible. The Board of Deputies of British Jews, The vice president of the organization, David Mendoza, is with us this evening. David, where you are? Please welcome David. European Literature Network, South African Jewish Museum, Traumatic Stress Clinic in London, Vilna Gaon Museum of Jewish History, the Lithuanian Culture Institute, Kaunas 2022, and not the least, Nathan Ray Productions and the team that are helping us to cover this event online and here as well. So thank you again, and thank you for being with us throughout all these 10 years. I very much hope that you will enjoy this year's Litvak Days. And now I wish to pass the floor to two distinguished guests who kindly agreed to give their greetings to all of us, to all of you this evening in a recorded manner. It will be Minister for European Neighborhood and the Americas of the Foreign Commonwealth and Development Office, Ms. Wendy Morton, and the UK Special Envoy for Post-Holocaust Issues and co-chair of the UK Holocaust Memorial Foundation, Honorable Lord Pickles.
Good evening, and so my warm wishes are with you all as we mark your 10th annual Litvak Days in London.
Thank you. I'm sorry that
I can't be with you in person. Today, we celebrate the positive contribution that Litvak communities have made to Lithuania, Britain, and South Africa. Over generations, the many Litvaks who have made their home in the UK have helped to shape our culture, academic thought, politics, and business. Many fled persecution and came in search of religious freedom. And freedom of religion or belief remains at the heart of British values and foreign policy. It is a human right and an emblem of diversity, strength, and hope. We mourn the Jewish communities annihilated in Lithuania and across Europe during World War II. And we remember those forced to rebuild their lives in new countries and those who were robbed of the opportunity to do so. As we reflect on those events and celebrate everything that Jewish communities bring to our societies, the UK government commits to continue our work together to build a better and safer future. The United Kingdom will always be a friend and strong ally of Lithuania and Litvaks. And today, we strengthen those friendships. Thank you.
It's a great pleasure to be involved in Litvak Days. It's the 10th annual one. It's a great opportunity to reflect on the importance of Lithuania and its Jewish community. Got real resonance in the UK because we think about 60% of our Jewish population has some connection with Lithuania. And of course, Lithuanians are home. Lithuanian people are a very valuable part of the British home life, that 200,000 live in the United Kingdom and play such an important part. I was brought up in Yorkshire, and the Lithuanian community was thriving and important, and I had many young friends within that community. It's this year we're looking at South Africa, Lithuania, and the connection with the United Kingdom. We of course have some of our distinguished historians like Seebach Montefiore. Family come from Lithuania, and of course our own our Prime Minister's great grandfather was born in Lithuania. But like all politicians, I'm desperately searching for a connection between myself and South Africa and Lithuania. And the best I can come up with is of course that I was housing minister for 5 years. And of course, Joe Slomo, who was the housing minister under Nelson Mandela, played an enormously important part in truth and reconciliation and bringing a peaceful end to apartheid, was born in South Africa. I'm a big film buff. I love the movies, and of course the one of our great actors, Lawrence Harvey, his family fled from Lithuania in 1934 to South Africa, and later he came to the United Kingdom and started an acting career, and appeared in two of my favourite films. The first one is Life at the Top, which was filmed not very far from where I was born, and The Manchurian Candidate, which was filmed nowhere near where I was born. Lithuania, in terms of its membership of the International Holocaust Remembrance Alliance, is a very key ally of the United Kingdom, and we greatly admire the work that Lithuania has done in terms of Holocaust remembrance. Like us, it's, Lithuania has it on the national curriculum, and the 130 tolerance centres that Lithuania hold is something that we greatly admire. So have a good day. Be very proud of the Jewish inheritance in Lithuania. Be very proud of the role that Lithuania plays in IRA.
Dear Excellencies, our honorable guests, I am more than honored and delighted to open the 10th Litvak Days, annually organized in London by the Lithuanian Embassy, and at the same time to welcome the audience virtually. The Litvak Days have become a tradition already, year by year inviting us all to commemorate the survival of the phenomenal Litvak identity. It is common knowledge that the Litvak history is rich in such areas as religion, philosophy, politics, and fine arts, and there are only few spheres not marked with their excellence. The legacy of the Litvaks spread widely, remarkably continuing to enrich many cultures to this day. Last year, we marked the 300th birth anniversary of the great Vilna Gaon, whose legacy epitomizes meaningful preservation of tradition based upon its rethinking. This remains as relevant in today's fast-evolving world as it was back in the 18th century. The Litvak Days for the past 10 years have continued to inspire and have made us to appreciate even more the significance of the Litvak legacy to the history and modern life of Lithuania, as well as further cherish its relations with all Lithuanian diasporas. And this year's Litvak Days are no exception. They continue telling the Litvak story, this time bring us to the South Africa, to hear insights from history to art, from personal narratives to collective one. I hope that by initiatives like this, we can contribute to the promotion of Litvak identity and its memorable heritage. By remembering, learning, and discussing more about the Litvak legacy, both in Lithuania and worldwide, we also learn lessons for our better present and future. I wish you all to enjoy your time at this year's Litvak Days.
Presented their welcome and remarks today. And now, as Ambassador mentioned, I would like to introduce a musical duo of Gleb Pyšniak and Rokas Zubovas, who actually teamed up specifically for this anniversary. And they will perform a program called Legends. They're both incredibly talented, I can vouch for that, incredible musicians, and they're very well known worldwide. Gleb, at the age of only 14, had already debuted as a soloist with the Lithuanian Chamber Orchestra in the Lithuanian National Philharmonic Society. He has received the highest accolades in significant national and international competitions, and an award from the President of the Republic of Lithuania for promoting Lithuania abroad. Rokas, on the other hand, has toured with concerts in South and North America and performed in most countries of Europe and Asia. He is also the director of the Mikalojus Konstantinas Čiurlionis House in Vilnius and has recorded all of the Čiurlionis piano works. Rokas has delivered on papers on various aspects of Čiurlionis' life at international conferences, museums, etc. He also organizes specific music festivals and other cultural events and has created the main character in a very, very popular feature film about Čiurlionis titled Letters to Sofia. Please welcome Rokas and Gleb to stage.
Thank you. Thank you. or the 10th Litvak Days in London. And our program, that's, I think, fit within the context of these wonderful events by telling stories. By telling stories by Lithuanian composers or composers from Lithuania who suddenly became legends. And with our performances, with our program, we're trying to extend their legacy, extend their stories, extend their existence among us. All composers, all three composers that we will share with you their music, became legends recently. All of them died just in these recent years, and all of them were very influential and instrumental in Litvak culture in Lithuania by their music for theater, by their inspirations, by their sharing of music and their talents with surrounding people. And first on our program was Anatolijus Šenderovas with his wonderful two songs of Shulamith, inspired by scripture. Anatolijus Šenderovas was a unique figure in Lithuanian musical culture, always with his warmth, with his very emotional, very spiritual music, drawing wonderful paintings in any context that he ventured to. And Vidmantas Bartulis, whose work I'm seeing my friend off, and we are taking one last look at the snow-covered February trees, was this very intriguing figure in Lithuanian arts, in Lithuanian musical arts, because of his love for various cultures. And in his canon of works, there is a many works entitled I like something, and he always included in his works little excerpts from other Greek composers from various generations, from various cultures, from Marlene Dietrich to Chopin to other geniuses of various cultural epochs. And now we will proceed with Sonata for violoncello and piano by Faustas Latėnas. Faustas Latėnas' fame in Lithuania rests on his music for theater primarily. And one of the main composers of Tuminas theater, of other theaters, he created the sonata while still a very young composer. And when we rehearsed it with Gleb, and when we thought about the picturesqueness of this, and already very acknowledgeable sense of theater in it, we thought these three movements of sonata create something like old sense of a small Jewish town, where the sorrow, spirituality, happiness, and everything is close together, knit together, and expressed in a very explicit, joyful, picturesque, and colorful way. So now we present to you Sonata by Faustas Latėnas for cello and piano, in 3 minutes.
Thank you. Thank you.
welcome them back.
Thank you. Thank you.
wonderful musicians. And thank you very much for that impromptu encore, which none of us expected. But most importantly, thank you to all of our attendees in person and online. And we really much hope to see you tomorrow at 10 a.m. BST. All the information can be found on our Facebook. And thank you again for being here with us and for opening the 10th Litvak Days this year. Thank you and have a lovely evening.